It's not over. If you got air to breathe, it's not over. Don't believe everything you see. You're a fighter. Weapons from somewhere higher. They light up when you closer. If God said it's not over, get up, cause it's not over. Tell that to this weight up on my shoulder. If joy comes in the morning, how much longer? Do I knock on heaven's door? Cause it won't open. Can't breathe, too broken to believe. See, I know that you've been here before. But if you look closer, the thing that didn't kill you made you stronger. That's why it's not over. Preach. It's not over. Yeah. If you got air to breathe, it's not over. Yeah. Don't believe everything you see. You're a fighter. Weapons from somewhere higher. They light up when you're closer. If God said it's not over, get up. Running, but you don't know where you headed. The prize is never greater than the lesson. The cross you carried really was your blessing. So breathe, can't fight what you can't see. Come on. See, I know that you've been here before. But look, see, you made it. All the nights you hated, they just made you stronger. That's why it's not over.
There was a time I thought my chance was gone.
Yes, yes, yes.
When the rain stopped, I knew I'd make it home. I feel better.
Hello, it's not over.
When the bags are packed and it's looking like the
hell.
Pull up to the ATM.
Hell, it's not over.
When your enemy turns out to be your best friend.
Hell, it's not over.
Give thanks, cause after each storm, new life begins.
See, your job and that money, it's just a resource. God is your source, and the source wants you to know.
It's not over. If you got air to breathe, it's not over. Don't believe everything you see.
Sunday afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Inspiration for Life Radio.
Yes.
I'm your host, Alicia Proctor, mm-hmm. being joined live here in the studio by my wonderful sister, Angela.
And it's always a pleasure to be here with you.
Amen.
And you all out there, and happy Easter.
Yes, happy Resurrection
yes,
Sunday.
Yes, absolutely.
Amen. This is truly a huge day
mm-hmm.
for everyone, especially the believers.
Yes.
There's just so much victory mm-hmm. in this past week. And,
yes.
you know, when you look at the world around you, nothing looks really victorious.
No.
But that's why we have to keep our eyes on Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. From Palm Sunday to mm-hmm. Good Friday to Passover.
Yes.
To, of course, Sunday is coming and
yes.
he is getting up out of the grave.
Amen. Amen.
Yes.
And this is, you know, what separates
yes.
Jesus from so-called religions.
Yes.
And this is what we tell you here on Inspiration for Life, because, you know, we fully believe in the Holy Bible.
Amen.
And, you know, again, Jesus, and my sister and I, we were having a conversation this week, and you know, she said it before, but, you know, Jesus, if you want to put him in the category of religion, but he is a relationship, you know, he's the only God that sacrificed his life for us.
Yes.
You know, with other so-called gods, you have to sacrifice something for them.
That's right.
And today, Easter Resurrection Sunday, is the day that made all the difference.
Amen.
All
to that. The difference. Yes,
and,
Lord.
You know, I just praise God and, and just thank him because, you know, he's alive.
And yes, he is.
He is alive.
Forevermore.
Forevermore, absolutely. Yes. And again, he's alive so you can have a relationship with
him.
You don't have a relationship with dead things.
Hello, somebody.
You have a relationship with things that are alive.
That's
and
right.
That's why we can today have our own personal relationship with Jesus.
Amen to that.
Amen.
You know, we're just so excited. You know that we're just excited about Jesus on
yes.
any given day.
Yes.
But this day in particular, because like Angela just said, this particular day just separates all religions,
yes.
you know, Jesus from all religions, because every other so-called God with a little g that other religions worship, you can find their bones. You can find their remains in their tomb. Amen?
Amen.
They did not rise from the dead.
Amen.
God did not raise them from the dead.
Amen.
He only raised Jesus Christ from the dead.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
And like Angela said, that means he's alive.
Yes.
Amen. No need in serving a dead God.
That's right.
He is alive forevermore, honey.
That's right.
And, you know, there's so many scriptures. I'm not even sure which ones we're going to go to today because there's just so much that just celebrates, you know, just adds to the excitement of today's meaning. Amen?
Yeah, absolutely.
That he is alive. And when he got up, he said, I have the keys to death, hell, and the grave.
Amen.
Hello, somebody. Mm-hmm. That sounds like a victorious
rising. That sounds
rising.
Like authority.
Yes,
all
it
authority
does.
And power.
Yes,
that's
it
what
does.
That sounds like. Praise God.
Yes, and that's in the scriptures, too.
Mm-hmm.
He said, all authority in heaven and
that's
in
right.
earth and under the earth has been given to me. Amen.
Amen.
Whew. That's the kind
God.
Of God you want to serve, honey.
That's right. Absolutely.
Yes, like she said, like Angela said, not a God that wants you to lay down your life for them, but one who laid down their life for you
Amen.
And is giving you his victory.
That's
Amen.
Right. Amen. Praise
yes.
God.
Praise
Thank
God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
We get excited about Jesus around here at any given time.
Yes, we do.
Yes. Thank God he's alive. Whew. He fulfilled the scriptures.
Yes.
You know, the prophets of old, back in the Old Testament, were prophesying about him.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Isaiah, I love the book of Isaiah. He prophesied about Jesus 700 years before Jesus actually came onto the scene, born through Virgin Mary, conceived by the Holy Spirit.
Came onto the scene in the earth.
On the earth,
he's always
correct.
Been,
he's
yes.
always,
he's
been,
always
here.
Been here.
Right,
mm-hmm.
he came on the scene,
yes.
born of a virgin. Amen. Anywho, Isaiah said he was wounded for our transgressions.
Yes.
He was bruised for our iniquities.
Amen.
The chastisement of our peace was laid upon him, and by his stripes we are already healed.
Amen.
And that was over 700 years before the crucifixion. And God, who always confirms his word, who always fulfills his word, his word never returns to him empty.
Amen.
That's exactly what happened. Amen.
Yes.
I think it was in the book of Song, I think it was David was prophesying where Jesus said, you will not leave my soul in Hades. Amen?
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Because Jesus had to fulfill the entire sin debt.
Yes.
That means all of the sins of the world went into him when he was on the cross.
Yes.
And when that happened, God had to look away from him. Mm-hmm. He could not look at him
yes.
because of our sins that
yes.
was on him.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the greatest exchange, you know, the righteous for the unrighteous.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
The just taking the punishment for the unjust.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, amen.
And because God had to look away from Jesus, He doesn't hide his face from us when we go to him in prayer. Because we are clothed. It's like we put on this coat. Mm-hmm. We are clothed in Jesus' righteousness.
Amen.
So God does not see Alicia and all her faults.
Right.
Amen.
Or Angela and all her faults.
All my shortcomings. Mm-hmm. He sees his perfect son, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because I've accepted him as my personal Lord and Savior.
Yes.
And therefore he says, Alicia, come boldly into my throne room. So we can communicate and talk together. You can pray to me and you can find help in the time of trouble.
That's right. You can pray directly to me.
And it's because of Jesus.
Yes.
Every bit of it is because of Jesus. Mm-hmm. Amen. Definitely not anything I've done besides accept Jesus as payment for my sins. Amen.
Amen.
That is it.
And because I know I've said here many a times before, and trust me, it still holds true. Thank God for his grace and mercy that every day he gives us a new portion of grace and mercy, because I need it every day.
Me too.
Every day. So that tells you I am nowhere near perfect.
Amen.
And I'll be the first to say it.
Yes,
but thank God, because of Jesus, I can go to the creator of all things and have a one-on-one conversation / prayer.
Amen.
You
with
know,
the God of the universe, the God of everything, the God who created everything.
Because of Jesus.
The God who just said what he wanted to see and it was created.
Mm-hmm.
He spoke everything into existence. Amen.
Amen.
That God.
Yes. The only God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
Well, we've gotten off track, but that's okay, because we are, again, excited about Jesus and what this day means.
Yes.
Several minutes ago, you heard Kirk Franklin with his song, It's Not Over.
That's
Amen.
Right.
Brother Kirk has opened us. He opens up Inspiration for Life Radio with that song every Sunday. Angela came up with a great idea. The ending song, probably for the rest of the year, is going to be My World Needs You Right Now.
Amen.
Which is
praise
also by
God.
Kirk Franklin. And it includes, I think her name is Sarah Reeves, Tasha Cobb, and Tamela Mann.
Yes.
And why did you suggest that, Angela?
Because it's so true. My world, the world, needs Jesus.
Yes.
We need him. I don't even want to think about where I would be without him.
Amen.
You know, as I said, I would probably be in some padded room somewhere.
Amen.
Maybe with half my hair pulled out, some long strands.
Right.
Half of it pulled out, because again, you may not understand what I'm talking about if you're not a believer, but you have this peace. Truly, when people say that, you know, hell could be happening all around you, but somehow you are in peace because you are connected with the one who, again,
the Prince
who,
of Peace.
The Prince of Peace.
Come on,
so
somebody.
That's how you can find peace. That's how you can have peace. Anyone who tells you that once you accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, the rest of your life is perfect, they are misleading
you. That's right.
They are misleading you.
That's right. Because he left us here in this world is a fallen world.
Yes.
And just like that song says, our world needs you right now.
Amen.
My world needs you right now,
yes.
Jesus. And I love the words of that song.
Yes.
She said, storms may come.
And yes, they do.
Meaning hard times might come your way while you're living in this earth.
Absolutely,
she
they
said,
will.
Storms may come, but when we call on your great name, all things change.
Amen. That's right.
Yes, because his name is a name above every name. Amen.
Yes, amen.
His name is above the name of cancer.
Yes.
His name is above the name of diabetes and heart attack and poverty and sickness and disease.
Amen.
His name is above depression and suicide spirits. Amen.
Yes,
his name is above oppression.
Mm-hmm.
His name is above everything, and everything must bow to the name of Jesus. Jesus.
Amen. Yes. Amen.
That's a powerful God right
That's
there.
Right. And it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what new so-called sin or what new it thing is in. It's already covered.
That's right.
It's already covered. He's not getting back on the cross.
Yes.
He's not dying again for that sin too.
Yes.
Oh, wow. We didn't think about that 2,000 plus years ago.
That's right.
This one caught us by surprise. No.
Yes.
That's not how it works.
His name is above it all.
Amen. Above all.
Yes. It's
yes.
above, you know, drug addiction and alcoholism and
And sex addiction. Yes. Sex addiction. Addictions. Yes. Yeah.
You name it.
Whatever it, in that song that Tasha Cobbs has.
Jesus saves.
Yeah, Jesus saves. And she said he can save you from that too.
That's right.
Whatever your that is.
That's right.
He can save you from that
Amen.
Too.
Amen. Amen. Mm-hmm. Yes. He's an all-powerful God. Mm-hmm. And on that note, the Bible says that Jesus saves to the utmost,
Amen.
Honey. There is nothing, there is no sin he cannot save you from. Mm-mm. Amen?
Amen.
Because all of our sins went into his body when he was on the cross, dying for the sins of the world.
Yes.
And then God did not leave it there. You know, mm-hmm. again, he had to pay the entire sin debt. Mm-hmm. So because of our sins that was on him, he did go into hell. And the Bible tells us that 3 days he was in hell.
Yes.
The Bible refers to it as Hades.
Mm-hmm.
But that's where he went and he spoiled principalities and
yes.
powers and made a show of them openly. In other words, he kicked their behind.
Mm-hmm. And probably he busted up their little party they
yes.
were having.
Yes.
Not knowing.
And he took from the devil mm-hmm. the keys to death, hell, and the grave.
Amen.
Amen. And said, oh, death, where is your sting?
Yes.
Oh, grave, where is your victory?
Amen.
Because you have been defeated by mm-hmm. Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Yes. So let's get
Praise
back on
God.
Track.
Yes.
We get so excited about
I don't
Jesus.
Even know what we're talking about today.
It's always about
Jesus. Yeah, it's always about Jesus. So, but I'm just telling you, this is not scripted.
No.
I don't even know what we, other than I know we're talking about Jesus. I don't know exactly which scriptures she's going to.
And, you know, on that note, oftentimes we just go off the cuff.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we do not practice the show.
Right.
A lot of times I get the show ready as I'm driving here.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just something about Jesus.
Amen. But there's always scripture to back
yes.
it up. As I said, it's not according to what we
That's
say.
Right.
It's according to what the Word of God
That's
has
right.
to say.
That's right.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So let's do a shout out to all of our listeners and viewers from last week.
Yes.
We so appreciate all of you who take time out of your busy day
Amen.
To spend time with us.
Mm-hmm.
We pray that we're saying something to encourage you
yes.
while you're on this journey called life.
Amen.
Amen. Because no matter how bad things look, no matter what the news is reporting,
mm-hmm.
no matter what people are talking about on social media, Jesus is alive
Amen.
And he is all powerful.
Praise
Amen.
God.
Amen. And he's got a way of turning any situation around.
Praise
Just
God.
Just one word from God changes any situation. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. So we must give shout out to our homeboys, homegirls,
yes.
those here in the United States of America, our home country.
Yes.
Thank God for you.
Absolutely.
Thank you for tuning in to Inspiration for Life Radio.
Yes, God continue to bless you.
Amen.
Yes.
To all of our brothers and sisters in Canada.
Yes,
thank
God
you
bless
so much
you.
For tuning in to Inspiration for Life Radio. To our brothers and sisters in the United Kingdom.
Yes, God bless you.
Thank you so much for taking time out and checking us out.
Mm-hmm.
To our brothers and sisters in Germany.
Yes.
God bless you.
God
and
bless
thank you.
You
so much for tuning in to Inspiration for Life Radio.
Amen.
And to our brothers and sisters in India.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
God bless you.
God bless you. And mm-hmm. to everyone in Norway who's tuned in to Inspiration for Life Radio.
Yes.
God bless you. And thank
Absolutely.
You so much. For checking us out. God
yes.
bless you.
God
Amen.
Bless you.
All right. So let's see here. I like to share with you guys my favorite tweet. If you're on Twitter, so am I, at Alicia Proctor. It's spelled AleyShaProctor. And if I'm blessed by your tweets and
yes.
I love to share them with our my mm-hmm. Twitter friends, then I'd love to share them with our listeners and viewers because I think it would be a blessing to them as well.
Absolutely.
Amen. So first and foremost, hang on here. First and foremost, we had from... And if y'all missed the Ten Commandments last night, I was doing some live tweeting. Just look at my Twitter feed.
Yes.
And you can get the whole gist of the whole 4-hour movie. Amen.
Yeah, we watch it every year like it's the first time because
Amen.
It doesn't get old.
It doesn't get old.
You know, seeing God work
yes.
and knowing that same power.
Yes.
Can be active in your life
yes,
today
yes.
if you have that personal relationship with him.
Amen.
That same power. And
because
he's the same God. Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
All right. The first one comes to us from our friends at... I had several graphics to share with you all this week. The first one comes to us from Calvary, and their Twitter handle is at through THRU underscore the underscore underscore word, through the word. And they show the New York City skyline on Easter 1956. And we have a graphic. Yeah, 1956. Wow. This is over 60 years ago. This is what the New York skyline looked like.
Oh, wow.
For Easter.
That's beautiful.
It says, a time when this nation wasn't ashamed of the cross of Christ.
Praise God.
Pray that we return there.
Amen. Yes, amen.
Amen. The next one comes to us from Brother Franklin Graham, and his Twitter handle is at Franklin underscore Graham. He says, as Christians, we look forward to Easter when we can celebrate a risen Savior.
Amen.
Jesus Christ rose from the grave and is alive today.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is. Our friends at Calvary, again, at Through the Word, they showed a graphic of the three crosses. They said, behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. And that comes to us from John 1:29 of the Bible. Do we have that graphic? But the three crosses. There we go. Behold the Lamb of God. The one that's most bloodied up there.
Yeah
that one. The one who took the flogging and has a crown of thorns on his head, causing even more blood to come out of him. That one. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Thank
of
you,
the
Jesus.
World. Again, it doesn't matter. If you live in the city, in town, in a rural area, it doesn't matter if where you live doesn't have a name.
Yes.
God knows you. And he died to take away the sins of the world.
Amen.
Not just a nation or a particular people, but the world.
The world. Mm-hmm. Amen. And he knows you by name.
Amen.
Amen. Brother Todd Atkins at Todd Atkins, A-D-K-I-N-S. Showed us another graphic, and I just love this one. It says, darkness fell, his friends scattered, hope seemed lost, but heaven just started counting to three.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Heaven started counting to three because on the third day, he was getting up out the grave.
Yes.
God the Father himself was going to wake up Jesus Christ and bring him back to life. Amen.
Amen.
And he was quoting Ed Bob Goff on that one, G-O-F-F. The next one comes to us from a friend at Jesus Saves. And they had that old, and I'm sure I showed this before, this old, looks like a car plate. And it says, Jesus loves you.
Amen.
And up in the corner, it says, it never expires.
Yes, amen. Amen. Thank God for that.
Yes, Lord. And the next one we have comes to us from TV One. And their Twitter handle is at TV One TV. And they showed a graphic. It said, Happy Easter. He is risen. Resurrection Sunday.
Yes.
A lot can happen in 3 days.
Amen. Praise God.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
A lot can happen in 3 days.
Yes.
Whew, honey, this is the most historical event ever.
Yes.
Ever. In 3 days.
That's right. That's right.
Our home church of the First Baptist Church of Glen Arden at FBCG said the resurrection is the most important story in human history.
Amen.
It separates Jesus from every other religious leader.
Yes. We said that.
Yes,
starting,
we did.
Yes, we did.
Yes,
I didn't even
we
know
did.
That.
Yes, amen. Amen. Yes. Amen. Honey, there is no comparison.
Yes.
It is all about Jesus.
Oh.
And also, I was driving down the road yesterday, and I came past this church, and they had on their church marquee, they just had one word, and the word was empty. The tomb is empty,
Amen.
Honey. Yeah, I had
Amen.
To pull over to the side of the road and snap a picture of that.
Yes.
Empty.
Amen.
Jesus'
That's right.
grave is empty.
That's right. It's no need for you to go to his tomb with flowers. He's not there.
Amen.
There's no need for you to go there with, I don't know, what else do you put on a grave?
Just flowers.
Yeah.
A wreath or something.
Yeah. If you want to talk to him You can just get on your knees or sit down and just start praying wherever right. you are.
Amen.
You can start praying and you are speaking to Jesus.
Yes, Lord. And yes. He hears you.
Amen.
And he'll speak back because he's yes. alive. Amen.
Amen.
Well, of course, when we come back, we're going to be talking about none other than the historical events that happened between Good Friday and Resurrection Sunday. And why that's important to you. Amen?
Yes, amen.
What does that mean for your own personal life? Mm-hmm. We're going to be talking about that in the next part of Inspiration for Life Radio. We're going to take a quick song break. Our brother Todd Delaney, that's a worshiping brother right there. He's going to give us some his beautiful rendition of the anthem. Amen? Here
amen.
On Inspiration for Life Radio.
Hallelujah, you have won the victory. Lift up your voice and say now. You have won it all for me. By His stripes we are healed. By His nail-pierced hands we're free. By His blood we're washed clean. And now we have the victory. And the power of sin is broken. Jesus overcame. Yeah. Yes, He did. He has won.
Jesus.
Welcome back to Inspiration for Life Radio. That was our brother Todd Delaney. That is a worshiping brother right there.
Yes.
And I would definitely encourage anybody to get his CD. It's called, A Worshiper's Heart.
Amen.
I have it here on my phone. Yes, it's called A Worshiper's Heart. And that is a worshiping young brother right there. Mm-hmm. Amen.
And you know, sorry to cut you off, but you know, a lot of times that's the secret to us feeling closer to God is worship.
Yes.
You know, that's the secret to us feeling like we have a personal relationship with Jesus.
Amen.
Is when you worship. And that's why we tell you here on Inspiration for Life, we strongly suggest, just come right out and tell you, have praise and worship music in your library.
Amen.
Because when your world is not okay, and
we all go through
that, all of us, you can listen to that, and then it becomes more about Jesus and less about your problems. And a lot of times, you get the answer to how to fix the problem right there while you're praising and worshiping, or it just doesn't seem as dramatic.
Yeah.
As it was before you started praising
and
worshiping.
Because you started to magnify God and he becomes bigger than your problems.
Absolutely.
Amen.
And the devil hates
he
that.
He hates that.
He hates that.
Because he'd love to see you depressed and crying and wondering where is God and why doesn't God hear you? Because he wants to tell you that God doesn't love you.
Right. He wants to tell you that he doesn't exist.
Right.
He wants you to blame God for everything that's going on in your life.
Yes.
And again, that's one of his tricks, but that's one of our weapons. Praise and worship is a weapon.
Yes, it is.
To the believer.
Yes, it is. And it can, it's like Pastor Marvin Sapp says, it confuses the devil. Amen.
Absolutely.
Because he's wondering, why is she praising God when I just told her that, you know, this is tough times are going to last always for you, honey.
Right. Yeah.
And you start praising God, and God becomes so much bigger than your problems. Amen.
Amen.
And your problems seem to be so small and getting smaller until it just kind of goes away. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Because you give God his rightful authority
his
position in your life. Amen.
Praise God.
Yes. All right. There's just so much we can say about the resurrection.
Yeah.
You know, I'm about half crazy just thinking about it all. But nevertheless, you know, we have been talking about angels here on Inspiration for Life Radio over the last several weeks. And, you know, we talked about how they are messengers of God. They only do and say what God tells them to do.
Amen.
They stand around God's throne waiting for an assignment from God himself. And he's given us ministering angels all encamped all around us.
Mm-hmm.
So I have my angels. They're assigned to me. Angela has hers.
Yes.
They're assigned to her. Amen?
Mm-hmm. Amen.
The Bible says that there's so many of them, they cannot be counted. Amen?
And I know some days my angels probably want to switch. Say, could somebody else watch over her? But no, God has assigned you to me. Thank you.
Amen. So let me briefly talk about the angel's role in the resurrection. Amen.
Yes.
So I'm going to go to Matthew 28, first of all, starting in the first verse. And if you've got a Bible, feel free to read along or go to BibleGateway.com, go to BibleVerses.com. I think it's called TheGospel.com.
Mm-hmm.
There's so many online Bible apps you can have so that you can have your word of God, your sword, your weapon against the devil with you at all times. Amen?
Amen.
Matthew 28, starting at the first verse. Now, after the Sabbath, as the first day of the week began to dawn, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat on it.
Hmm.
Now, the stone was huge because the religious people of that day, they knew that Jesus kept saying, after 3 days, I'm going to rise from the dead.
Mm-hmm.
And they wanted to make sure this did not happen.
Yes. Yes. It was the religious people of the day.
Yes. It was the high priest and the Pharisees and the elders.
Yes.
And so they had actually gotten some guards and they're like, we're going to roll a huge rock in front of this, his tomb, so that nobody can go in there and steal his body and say he's risen from the dead.
Yes.
In addition to that, they had petition I guess it was Pilate, and asked for some guards to guard the door of Jesus' tomb to make sure none of this happened.
Right. But to make sure no one broke in and took his body.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And now, really, do you think your human efforts can squash God's plans?
Amen.
No.
Amen.
No. Mm-hmm. But let's take another look. And behold, there was a great earthquake. The earthquake came because God sent an angel down. Mm-hmm. That's a lot of power right
yes.
there. And keep in mind, they're just messengers. Mm-hmm. They're not God himself. They're not to be worshipped. Mm-mm. They just do what God says. But by him coming to the earth, this angel, it caused an earthquake. Mm-hmm. And it says he just rolled away the door and he sat on it. He made a chair out of it. Where it took several guards to push that yes. stone in front of the door. He just flicked it off, mm-hmm. rolled it, and just sat on it mm-hmm. while he waited for Jesus to get up and come out of the grave. It says, verse 3, and it's still talking about this angel, his countenance was like lightning. Mm-hmm. And he was clothed as white as snow. And the guards shook for fear of him and became as dead men. They just passed mm-hmm. out. They just passed out. And then the angels, verse 5, but the angel answered and said to the women, remember Mary Magdalene and the other Mary, mm-hmm. do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. He is not here. He is risen as he said. Mm. Come, see the place where the Lord lay, and go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. And indeed, he is going before you into Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you. Mm-hmm. So they went quickly and went to go start spreading the word. Jesus is up. So yes. anyway, in verse 9, it says, and they went to tell the disciples, behold, Jesus met them saying, rejoice. So they came and held him by the feet and worshiped him. See, God's always going to have a witness in the earth.
Yes.
There was a witness to see this angel come down. Mm-hmm. There was a witness to see him roll away the stone.
Yes.
There was a witness to see Jesus alive and walking around after his death.
Amen.
Amen. It says, and then it goes on to talk about how let's start in verse 11. Now, while they were going, behold, some of the guards came into the city and reported to the chief priests all that had happened. You know, the chief priests were about to have a heart attack.
Mm-hmm.
And they said in verse 12, when they had assembled with the elders and consulted together, here you have the chief priests and the elders consulting together. Mm-hmm. They gave a large sum of money to the soldiers saying, look, we're going to get our story straight.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 13, this is what you tell them. It
yes,
says,
this is the lie you're going to tell.
That's right. His disciples came at night and stole him away while we slept. And if this comes to the governor's ears, we will appease him and make you secure. So they took the money and did as they were instructed. And this saying is commonly reported among the Jews until this day. So they gave him a large amount of money and said, this is the story.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all not going to tell them what really happened. Mm-hmm. You're going to say that his disciples came and stole his body away. As if your human efforts are going to stop mm-hmm. God's will and what he has already said is going to happen.
And again, these are the religious people.
That's right.
These are the religious people. That's why we say here on Inspiration for Life, religion can't change
That's
your life.
Right.
Only a relationship with Jesus.
That's right.
I'll say it again. What we're talking about here in the scriptures, the one coming up with a scheme, getting money together to pay people to lie.
Yes.
These are the head of the religious.
That's right.
The religions, or the religious people.
That's right.
So again, religion cannot change you.
Amen.
Only a relationship with Christ.
Amen to that.
Mm-hmm.
Also, let me skip over to John 20. This also gives an account of the resurrection. Let's start at verse 3. It says, Peter therefore went out and the other disciples and were going to the tomb. So they both ran together, and the other disciple outran Peter and came to the tomb first. And he, stooping down and looking in, saw the linen clothes lying there, yet he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came following him and went into the tomb, and he saw the linen clothes lying there. Get this part. And the handkerchief that had been around his head, not lying with the linen clothes, but folded together in a place by itself. Now,
what does that mean?
What does that mean?
What does that mean?
So you have the linen clothes, because Jesus is up. He's been resurrected, but his clothes are there. Mm-hmm. But over to the side, there was a handkerchief that was around his head, folded up by itself. Mm-hmm. That was a sign that he left for people to say, I'm coming back.
Amen.
I'm coming Praise back. God. Because if you go to a fine restaurant and they give you, you know, a handkerchief, I mean, a napkin.
Yes.
You fold the napkin. Like, say you get up to go to the restroom. Mm-hmm. Usually the waiter will come back. They'll look at your plate, see you still have food there. Think, okay, well, they're going to come back and finish eating. Mm-hmm. So they'll pick up your napkin and fold it for you and put it on the table.
Yes.
That folded napkin in all cultures just about means I'm coming back.
Yes.
I'm returning.
Amen.
I'm not done. Amen.
Amen. Praise God.
That is so wonderful. I remember.
Yes.
That is so wonderful.
Amen.
And going on, verse 8, then the other disciple who came to the tomb first went in also, and he saw and believed. For as they, yet they did not know the scriptures, but he must rise again from the dead. He must, because he said so.
Yes.
And then also, I'll skip down to verse 11. But Mary stood outside the tomb weeping, and she wept. And as she wept, she stooped down and looked into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting, one at the head and the other at the feet, where the body of Jesus had lain, past tense. Mm-hmm. When they saw her, they said, "Woman, why are you weeping?" And she said, "Because they have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." It says, now while she was talking, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, and did not know it was him. She thought it was a gardener. And he said, "Why are you crying? Who are you seeking?" And she said, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him. Tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." And Jesus said to her, "Mary." And she turned and said, "Rabbi." She recognized that this was him that was live and in the flesh, and she was talking to him. Mm-hmm. Amen. And so, of course, she had to go and tell all the disciples, because God is always going to have a witness in the earth.
Amen. Amen.
There was also in here where it said how Jesus appeared to thousands. And it said, I find that scripture, where he would go into where the disciples were in the Bible. Oh, here it is right here. And after 8 days, his disciples, verse 26, were again inside. They were inside of a house. Mm-hmm. And Thomas with them. Jesus came, and it says, the door being shut. But he stood in the midst of them. In other words, he didn't need to open the door to come in. He just showed up, honey, okay? That's the kind of power he has.
Amen.
He doesn't need you to open the door. Mm-mm. He just showed up.
That's right.
And this is after he was resurrected. Amen?
Amen.
And also, and you might say, well, what does this have to do with me, Alicia? Mm-hmm. You need to get excited about the resurrecting power of Jesus, because the scriptures tell us that that the same power that raised Jesus from the dead, he will quicken your mortal bodies. Amen?
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Yes, 1 Thessalonians tells us, and let me find that for y'all. Everybody wants to text and call me while I'm on the radio here, but I'm not going to pay them any attention.
Yes. Because we have a word to get out to you all.
So in 1 Thessalonians, let me find it. It talks about when Jesus comes back. Remember that folded napkin? Mm-hmm. He said, "I'm coming back."
Yes, amen.
And he said, hang on, it's coming. Okay. Here we have 1 Thessalonians 4:16. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout and with the voice of an archangel and the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Yes. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And thus we shall always be with the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible refers to Jesus as being the firstborn amongst the dead, meaning he was the first to be resurrected. Mm-hmm. The Bible tells us that all believers are going to be resurrected when Jesus comes back.
Amen.
That is amazing.
Yes, it is.
That is amazing, honey.
Yes, it is.
So that's only for the believers.
Mm-hmm.
That is only for the believers. You might say, Alicia, well, how do I become a believer? How do I get as crazy excited as you and your sister are about Jesus? Well, honey, Jesus loves you.
Yes, he does.
He loves you as if it was only you here on this earth, and it was only your sins that he had to go to the cross and die for. He loves you just that much.
Amen.
And he'll always love you. The Bible says, though, that you must accept him as your personal Lord and Savior. Now, let me share the scriptures with you in Romans. Mm-hmm. Romans 10, verses 9 through 11. That's not it.
Yeah, because when you accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, you accept his payment for your sin.
That's right. So that you don't have to
have to pay for them.
Because you can't. The way you pay for your sins is with blood. Your own blood, your own life, your soul.
Right.
Which means that you would have to go to hell. I hate to say it, but that's the word. Amen.
Amen.
That's the word.
And again, you know, God does not send anyone to hell. God did not create hell for human beings.
That's right. It was created for the devil and his demons.
Yes, but because God created us with our own free will, if you choose not to receive the payment that Jesus paid for your sins, then you have to pay for your sins.
Amen. And that is too great a burden for anybody.
Yes.
And you don't have to pay for your own sins.
You
can just accept Jesus' payment for your sins on the cross of Calvary.
Yes.
And have eternal life with God in his glory in heaven forever and totally miss out on hell.
Amen.
Amen. That sounds like the great exchange to me. Amen.
Absolutely.
I'll take that over hell any day.
Any day.
Amen. So Romans 10 verses 9 through 11 says that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, the resurrection we've just been talking about, you will be saved. That's a guarantee.
Yes, it is.
Verse 10, for with the heart one believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Verse 11, for the scripture says, whoever believes on him will not be put to shame. Amen.
Amen.
If you believe on Jesus Christ and ask him into your heart, heaven is guaranteed to be your home.
Yes.
And once you stand before God, God will not say, depart from me, I never knew you. He will say, welcome home. Enter into the joy of your Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So how do you get there?
Yes.
I'm going to pray the sinner's prayer.
Mm-hmm.
And if you pray this prayer after me, the Bible says you will be saved.
Yes.
It's not an if, it's not a maybe, it's a guarantee. You will be saved. And we take God at his word.
Amen.
Because he's not a man that he should lie. Amen.
Nor the son of man that he should repent.
That's it.
Amen.
Amen. So here we go. Say, dear Lord.
Dear Lord.
I come to you.
I come to you.
As a sinner.
As a sinner.
I believe.
I believe.
That Jesus is your son.
That Jesus is your son.
He came to this earth.
He came to this earth.
He died on the cross. For my sins.
He died on the cross for my sins.
And you raised him from the dead.
And you raised him from the dead.
I ask Jesus to come into my heart.
To come into my heart.
And make me.
And make me.
A child of God.
A child of God.
I repent of my sins.
I repent of my sins.
And I receive Jesus.
And I receive Jesus.
As my Lord.
As my Lord.
And as my Savior.
And as my Savior.
And in Jesus' name.
And in Jesus' name.
I am saved. Amen.
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 Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen.
If you said that prayer, that is the best decision you will ever make. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
And what do they want to do next, Angela?
And next, what you want to do is you want to become connected to the local man or woman, meaning the local man or woman of God, meaning your local church.
Yes.
And you want to become connected to a Bible preaching, Bible teaching church, the Holy Bible.
Yes.
Because in there, God has so many benefits that come along with salvation.
Amen.
If being saved were not enough.
Yes.
There are scriptures for any issue in life. There is a scripture for it. And that's how you also build your faith.
Yeah.
And God knows that he wants you to know that he loves you. He wants you to know the other benefits that are in the Bible for you. So that is what you want to do.
Yes.
And he wants you to, you know, again, to know that Jesus is alive.
Amen.
He wants you
forever.
To have that personal relationship.
That's
with
right. Amen to that. Mm-hmm. So you need a pastor, honey.
Yes.
So you want to get into, like Angela said, your local Bible teaching church. So you can grow the Holy in the things Bible. Of God. Amen. You mm-hmm. can grow in your relationship with yes. the Lord. And God would love nothing less. Amen. Amen. He would love for you to just grow in your relationship with Him. He would love for you to talk to Him in mm-hmm. prayer. Amen.
Amen.
Bring all your problems to Him, the big and the small ones.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. Because He's into the details, honey.
Amen.
The Bible says God will perfect that which concerns us.
Amen.
So if we're concerned about it and we take it to God and pray, God said He'll perfect, He'll handle it.
Yes.
And the Bible
God.
Says that He's able to do something about our problems. Amen.
Amen.
He's able to do exceedingly abundantly, far above we could ask or think, mm-hmm. according to the power that works in us. He's not just listening to your problem, but He's able to do something
Amen.
About it. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
Because He's just that kind of a God.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
So we will be back here next Sunday at 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Mm-hmm.
Please tell a family member, a friend, a coworker, a schoolmate, a neighbor, mm-hmm. Enemy, everybody.
Yes.
To tune in to Inspiration for Life Radio. We pray that you have a blessed week, a wonderful Resurrection Sunday.
Yes.
Remember that Jesus is alive forevermore.
Amen.
Death could not hold Him. Acts said it was impossible for death to be able to hold Him.
That's right.
Couldn't happen.
Could
impossible
not.
For death to be able to hold Him.
No.
That's the kind of God we serve. That's
yes.
the type of team you're on. He's a winner. He's
Amen.
Our champion, and He's alive forevermore.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. And it's fine for you to go to the back of the Bible in
yes.
Revelations where you see we win.
Amen. Spoiler alert.
We win,
honey.
Yes.
We win.
We win. You know, again, God is the only God who knows the end from the beginning.
That's
and
right.
we win.
Amen. As
yes.
Pastor Alistair Begg said, checkmate has already occurred.
Yes.
Jesus wins, honey.
Amen.
As said before, Brother Kirk Franklin with Sarah Reeves, Tasha Cobb, and Tamela Mann is going to take us home with
yes.
My World Needs You Right Now.
Amen.
Honey, it says, at His name,
yes.
all things change. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Thank
Praise
you, Jesus.
God.
Have a blessed week just on purpose.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. God bless you.
Show me your face, fill up this space. My world needs you right now. My world needs you right now. I can't escape being afraid. Fill me with you. My world needs you right now.
Show me your face, fill up this space. My world needs you right now. My world needs you right now. I can't escape.
To you right now, erase us. keep